Hello friends, welcome back to Design Patterns video series. In this video, I'm going to discuss why do we need to create the Singleton class as shield in C# with examples. Please watch our previous video before proceeding to this video where we discussed the basic concept of Singleton design pattern with an example. At the end of this video, you will understand the following pointers. What is the role of shield keyword in C#? What is the role of a private constructor in C#? Then we will discuss one concept, that is nested classes in C#. And finally, we will discuss why do we need to use the shield keyword in the singleton class, as we already have a private constructor within the class which will restrict the class for further inheritance. So before proceeding further, the most important point that you need to keep in mind is we need to use the singleton design pattern when we need to ensure that only one instance of a particular class is available at any given point of time for the entire application. With this keep in mind, let us proceed. The following singleton class we have created in our previous video. As you can notice, here we created the class as shield, as well as we have a parameterless private constructor. Right now let us understand why the singleton class is shield in C# with one example. So let's move to Visual Studio. This is the singleton class that we have created in our previous video. Here we have created the class as shield and the constructor as private. To understand the need and importance of shield keyword in C#, let us first remove the shield keyword from the singleton class definition. Then we will create another class with the name derived singleton. So let's create another class, that is public class derive derived singleton. And let's inherit this derived singleton class from the singleton class. Once you do the same, you will get one compile time error, that is singleton.singleton constructor is inaccessible due to its protection level, right? That means we are getting this compilation error is because of the private constructor that we have in the singleton class. Now you might be thinking that as we have a private constructor within the class, so it is not possible to derive this class. Then why do we need to apply the shield keyword to the singleton class? To understand this concept, let us move the derived singleton class inside the singleton class. That means we have to move this class definition inside the singleton class, right? Once we move the derived singleton class within the main singleton class, then the derived singleton class becomes a nested class, or you can say a child class of the main singleton class. So here first, we need to understand what is a nested class, right? Whenever we define a class within another class in C#, then the inner class is called a nested class or child class. In our example, we defined the derived singleton class within the main singleton class, right? I hope you understand what is nested class in C#. Further, if you notice, once we move the definition of the derived singleton class within the singleton class, then the compilation error is also gone, right? Now we are not getting any error. So let us modify the main method of the program class to access the nested class, right? This is the code that we have already wrote in our previous video. Now let us create an instance of the derived singleton class. To create an instance of the nested class, we need to specify the outer class first. That is, the outer class is singleton followed by the dot operator, and we have to specify the derived singleton class. Then we can call the print details method on the derived singleton class object. Right. Now let's run the application and see what we will get. So we are getting the above output, right? The output clearly shows that the counter value has incremented to 2, right? You can see the counter value is currently 2, that is incremented to 2, which proves that the private constructor executed twice, right? If you look at the constructor of the singleton class, here we have printed the counter value, right? Initially the counter value is 1, initially the counter value is 0. When the first time it executed, it will increment the counter value to 1. Again, if it is executed, then it will increment the counter value to 2, right? So as we are seeing the counter value to 2, that means this private constructor executed twice, right? So by removing the sealed keyword, we can inherit the singleton class, and also possible to create multiple object of the singleton class. This violates the singleton design principle, right? Now let's make the singleton class as sealed, right? So let's make the singleton class as sealed. And once we make the singleton class as sealed, we are getting one compilation error in the derived singleton class, that is singleton.derived singleton cannot derive from the sealed type singleton. So from this point, we can conclude that the private constructor in C# will help us only preventing any external instantiation of the class, and the sealed keyword only prevents the class inheritance, right? The way we implement the singleton class is not a thread safe. This implementation of the singleton class allows two different threads at the same time to be evaluated, the test condition, that is instance equals to null, to be true, and they both create the instances, which violates the singleton design pattern principle. That we will discuss in the next video, how to implement thread safe singleton design pattern. So let's move to the presentation. What is nested class in C#? Whenever we define a class within another class, then the inner class is called a nested class or child class. As you can see in the diagram, so the singleton class is the outer class and the derived singleton class is the inner class or nested class. What is the role of private constructor in C#? The private constructor in C# will help us only preventing any external instantiation of the class. What is the role of sealed keyword in C#? The sealed keyword will prevent the class inheritance. In the next video, I'm going to discuss how to handle thread safety singleton class in a multi-threaded environment. In this video, I try to explain why the singleton class is sealed in C#. In case you need the code and text version of this video, then the link for the same is provided in the video description section. I hope you enjoy this video and understand why we need to declare the singleton class as sealed, as we already have a constructor in the singleton class which is private and parameterless. Thank you for watching this video.